Hallelujah. Uncle Albert, man, stop taking medicine.
I don't take no medicine.
Yes, you do. Listen, what is that? You're in your past. It's a birthday. You're not going to hurt. Take a medicine.
You see these scars? You see these scars? I got to live with this for life. You don't.
Yeah, but when you've been through slavery, man, it's the past.
I got to live with these scars. You don't.
Now, my dog is big, mom.
So, look at it.
What's going on here?
Uncle Albert don't want to take his medicine.
Nobody told you to come out.
I can't.
Go.
Take your medicine.
I'm hurt.
It's too long
for that
grace
to die. So?
Take your medicine. Look at
me. I'm done. I give up. I ain't taking no medicine. Get up! 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 Yes, it hurts, but Jesus is the mender of broken hearts. Yes, it's confusing, but Jesus makes the crooked places straight. Yes, a lot of time has gone by, but Jesus is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Stop your weeping. Stop your mourning. Get out of your feelings. Jesus is here, and he's calling you to get up. You got to put your trust in his hand and get up from that situation. Get up from that moment. Get up from that season, because you are not done. Yes, it died. Yes, it's stinking. Yes, it's lifeless. But there is one who has conquered death, hell, and the grave. And though he has delayed his coming for a season, he is now here, and he just calls your name to get up. Cast down the spirit of the zombie. Stones that are preventing the light of
Got it.
There's a leak in this old building. for coming to Harvest Life View. Get up, Black History Month performance. I just want to introduce everybody. First, we have Maya.
I just happened to meet a young lady. So I started telling everybody, I'm going to Dayton, Ohio, because I'm getting married. Well, she ain't here. Because when I think about it, God told me this. He said, I said you had to leave Pennsylvania. I ain't tell you nothing about you going to get married. That's your mess. I told you what I wanted you to do. But you weren't going around telling everybody you're going to get married. Nothing personal. You know, the person was a very nice person. But when we do things on our own, it never work out.
Right, man.
If you ain't got God in the mix of anything that you're doing, it will never work. I've been doing this since 1976. I've been in movies. I've been in plays. I've been in all that. But see, I put me first. And I left God on the back burner. And until I put him in the mix of what I was doing, wasn't nothing going right.
Right.
I was everything, didn't have no way, because I didn't trust him. I didn't trust people. Because you said you're going to be with me, but when the times got rough, you were nowhere to be found.
Amen.
You know, so God started putting people in my life. Now, I don't want to hold y'all no longer. What I want to do for these children is this. If y'all are willing to continue to practice with her daughter, and I'll say by May, I want you to do the same routine. Everything that you just done, but I'm going to put it on television.
Oh.
And the only thing about it is, you got to be prepared to do the work. That's one of the things about acting and praise dancing. You gotta be committed. Don't come in half-stepping. If this young lady is a director, she's directing y'all, listen to her. She knows what she's talking about. I always watch her. She's good. She's good. And all y'all good. Really, y'all really are. I mean, it takes a lot to get up there and do some of the things that you do.
Amen.
And to perform in front of people.
Amen.
You know, especially being young. But if you put your heart and soul into what you're doing, is this something that you really want to do? All of us are not basketball players. We're not all LeBron James. We're not all football players. Find something else that you're suited at. While you're in school, they got drama classes. You'll be surprised once you get involved in it, and where it can take you. You know, it can take you far. You got a lot of children actors that do all right, but you got to be committed, and your family got to be committed and want to help you, not push you. Help them. And when you see them doing stuff, help them. See, we have a tendency of, when our children is in the back room singing, oh, shut up. You're making all that noise, and guess what happened? You just go away a single. And the things that they do, encourage them. Work with them. If you think your child can be something, help them. Don't disencourage them. Because, the tongue is the worst thing in our mouth. And see, we can hurt a child's feelings real easy by telling them, go somewhere and shut up and sit. And guess what? You might have a big time singer or actor or something like that on your hands, and they'll take you for where you are. You might not never have to work again if you got the right children. But I want to say thank you. But what I want to do is I'll check with, should I know his name?
Micah.
I'll stay in touch with Micah. And hopefully, maybe sometime in May, because I have quite a few things that I'm working on. But I'm serious. If you guys really want to recreate this, I'll get it put on DATV. I mean, I ain't the number one man down there, but I did win Producer of the Year award last year. And I ain't stopped struck yet. So, if I can help you seriously, you know, because I have a couple of plays coming up too. So, you know, I want to write a play about children and a gospel play using praise dances. That's another thing that I got coming in, hopefully in June. I'm doing it's not a play, It's a gospel event using praise dancers. Mm. And the name of that is You Don't Know My Story. Mm. And guess what? Through your praise dancing, you're going to be telling my story. From where I began to where I'm at today. So thank y'all, but give these kids one more hand. Encourage them. Give them a hug. Love them. Love them. And keep pushing. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay, if anybody want to take, just get with me so I can get your name down. The CD's only $5, and I can get you a copy of it. You get it within a week or two, but we do have it on CD. Amen?
Amen.
We have two more baskets
to go give away. Okay. Do anybody enjoy
yourself? Yes. Yeah.
We just want to give thanks to our pastor and our youth leaders, Sister Micah. That's what we got these flowers for.
Oh.
Yeah, we just want to show our appreciation to y'all and just to show that we love y'all so much and we appreciate what y'all do for us.
Thank you.